So, Lewis, I have inside of my wallet a single folded playing card.
Okay.
And in a moment, I'm going to ask you to name a playing card out loud. But we're going to find this in an interesting way because, of course, as you know, with the words that I say, the actions that I make, I can probably influence your decision quite substantially.
Mm.
So we're going to discount that by getting you to do a little visualization. You will make all of the choices and you'll gradually whittle down the cards.
Let's do it.
So I want you to imagine that you walk into a casino. The doors swing open and it reveals a card table in front of you.
Mm-hmm.
A dealer is setting up for a game that you've never seen before. He's dealing out the cards into two piles, one of which contains the number cards, ace, two, three, four, all the way up to 10. And the other pile contains all of the court cards, the jacks, queens, kings of clubs, hearts, spades, and diamonds.
Okay.
You've got the opportunity to take one of these off the table. Which one would you like to take?
The picture cards.
The picture cards. Mm. So you take them off the table, you spread them in front of you, and you're going to reach out, take one with your other hand, and all the others are going to drop away. Which one would you like to take?
The Jack of Diamonds.
The Jack of Diamonds. So from an entire deck of cards, you went through this visualization, you decided to pick up the court cards, you decided to focus your attention on the Jack of Diamonds. No other cards exist. In the same way that no other cards exist inside of my wallet, except for one, the Jack of Diamonds.
Nice.
And at this point, you can even show the wallet empty. Do you believe in destiny?
Probably not.
I don't know. I think you can maybe change your own destiny with hard work, maybe.
There's no way really to prove whether it exists or not. I mean, the most that you'll get is sort of a vague idea. Like if you were to see a virtuoso concert pianist, you might understand that his calling is to tickle those keys. But for the rest of us, it's pretty much impossible to know whether we're on the path we're supposed to be or not. Some people, though, do believe in destiny. They believe so much that they put all their money down on the roll of a dice or the deal of a card in a casino. Inside of my wallet, there's a single folded playing card. And in a moment, you're gonna name a single playing card. But we're gonna do this in an interesting way. So Raph, if I could ask you to close your eyes, and I want you to imagine seeing two giant doors in front of you. They swing open to reveal a glamorous room, a casino. You walk forward directly to a card table where a dealer is setting up for a game that you've never seen before. He's dealing out all of the cards into two piles, one of which contains all of the spot cards, the ace through 10 of clubs, hearts, spades, and diamonds. And in the other pile, of course, is all of the picture cards, the jacks, the queens, the kings of clubs, hearts, spades, and diamonds. And you're going to get the opportunity to take one of these off the table. Either the picture cards or the number cards, it's up to you.
Picture cards.
The picture cards. I want you to spread those cards in front of you, and you'll notice there's two distinct colours there. There's red cards and there's black cards. Again, just choose which ones you want, either the red cards or the black cards.
Go for the reds.
Perfect. So you can throw the blacks over your shoulder, they no longer exist. So now, in your hands, you've just got the Jack, Queen, and King of Hearts and Diamonds. Yep. This time, you're going to eliminate two of these values. So you're going to eliminate all of the Jacks, all of the Queens, all of the Kings. Choose any two.
Queens and Kings.
We'll go for the Queens and the Jacks.
The Queens and the Jacks are gone. So all you've got left is the King of Hearts and the King of Diamonds. You can open your eyes. As promised, inside here, one single folded playing card. You're gonna make one final choice. Which card would you like to eliminate? Either the King of Hearts or the King of Diamonds?
So eliminate the King of Diamonds.
So that would leave you with the King of Hearts.
Yeah.
I did say it'd be almost impossible for you to get this. But perhaps destiny does exist after all.
So, if I was to ask you if you believe in time travel, I imagine you'd say no. But it's not like it is in the films, you see. To me, real time travel is when you are clearing out stuff from your family home and you find an old box. And inside the box is an object or an item that you haven't seen or even thought about for years. And the moment you pick up that item, you're instantly transported back in time to another moment in your life. And suddenly your head fills with emotion and memories, and your heart just bursts with all of those same feelings again. And you relive the moment once again. And then after a time, you fade and you come back to the present moment, only this time you feel different. Now, those might just be memories, but what you're feeling is undeniably real. And this is also why some people keep little memory boxes so they can store things from their life so they can relive these moments again. And I want to try something based on that. So, Fee, could you please think of something from your life, something from your past, an object or an item that you maybe haven't seen or thought about for years, something that if I was to place it in your hands right now, it'd give you those same feelings that I just explained. Can you think of something? Don't tell me what it is, but if you could... Yeah, no problem. Something that's important to you. It doesn't have to be something that you still have. Just an item from your past that's important to you.
I'll just think of the first thing then.
Yeah, that's perfect. So here's what we'll do. I'm going to hand you a piece of paper and a pen. And I'm not going to look, and don't show the cameras either, but I want you to draw a very basic picture of whatever this thing is. It doesn't have to be perfect or detailed, just as long as it's recognizable so we can show the camera at the end. And when you've done your drawing, you can write underneath it if you want to. You can write what it is, but when you've done it, turn it over and we'll stick it back in there and we'll continue. All right? So I'll leave that with you along with the pen, and I won't look and don't let anybody else see.
I'm not a very good drawer, but I'll do
it. Nobody is a worse artist than me. Don't worry. Perfect. And is it turned over so that we can't see what it is? Excellent. Now I promise I won't look, otherwise there'll be no point in us doing this. Perfect, and we'll stick it inside there. You see, this is going to represent the box. For this to work, your memory has to spend some time in the box. Can you recap the... Oh, you've done it. Can you hold your hand out like this for me? And we'll leave this there. I'll get rid of the pen and place your other hand flat on top. All right, then. So just think about this item, whatever it is, and pay attention to any feelings you get or any memories that appear in your mind, any people connected to it, and any emotions that you associate with this thing. And it's my job to simply observe, not what I can see, but what I can feel. All right, and I'm noticing a change in you already. Now, there's a smile on your face, so this is something from your childhood. This reminds you of being a kid. There's a sense of joy here, but also a sense of loss. This is something that feels like it went missing a long time ago, but you still have it safe somewhere. There we go. Actually, you can open your eyes for a second for me. I'm gonna write down a couple of things that I'm seeing. If this was in front of you right now, it wouldn't talk to you, would it? But when you were a kid, it probably would have done. I've got a feeling it's something like this. Okay. You have to forgive my terrible art skills. All right. So if you could just lift that hand for a moment. I'm going to do a little swap. And don't look just yet. All right, then. That's what I feel this is. Before you look at that, can you tell us all, what did you decide to put in the box?
It was my Teddy Ruxpin Christmas present, and it spoke to you through a tape.
Okay. Oh, so that makes sense. It spoke to you. All right, excellent. And being honest, how do you feel now, as opposed to how you did before we even began? Do you feel those same emotions coming back?
Yeah, straight back to childhood and happy memories, but no idea where it is now.
Interesting. But you're still feeling it.
Yeah.
And I think I know what's causing that. You see, a moment ago I asked you to think of something that I could place in your hands that would give you these feelings that you're experiencing right now. And you said your teddy bear. Take a look at my drawing.
Much better than mine.
And there we go. And I am curious as well. I do have to see. Let's have a little look. Oh, and there we go. I'm happy with that. And you can keep this and keep my drawing as well. And there's a new memory for the memory box. All right, thank you. Yeah, absolutely.